Hello, Boss of Word. Welcome to Books and Blog Center. After Oles and Usyk defeated Tunabellew by stoppage, he called out the unified heavyweight of the world, Anthony Joshua, for a future matchup, saying that he would like to fight Joshua in the future. You know, Usyk is a very likable guy. You know, I cannot hate him. You know what I mean? I cannot. There's nothing for me to hate on this guy for. The first thing is that this guy is not an asshole. He's not a guy who talk too much. He doesn't talk too much. He's a guy who make a statement in the ring. He doesn't want to talk shit and then end up getting knocked out. He's a guy that just keep quiet and make things happen in the ring. And fighting Tunabellew, knocking out Tunabellew, I didn't really see that coming. I thought he was going to outbox Tunabellew. And I didn't see a knockout. I saw Tunabellew knocking him out, but I didn't see him knocking out Tunabellew. So I was kind of surprised when Bellew got knocked out. But on the other hand is that Bellew was actually outboxing Oleksandr Usyk before he got stopped. I mean, we all saw that, right? Even though you might say that, okay, Usyk allowed Tunabellew to waste all his energy before he attacked him. You can say that, but also you can also say that Tunabellew put up a very great strategy until he got gassed up. Tunabellew was gassed out, you know what I mean? So, but fighting AJ, how will it be? I think Usyk needs to step up in the division first. He needs to fight guys like Chisora, Carlos Takam, Joe Joyce and Daniel White, if he can beat all those guys. But I think against Daniel White is going to be even more of a nightmare, because Daniel White is not going to box with Usyk. He knows that Usyk is the better boxer. He's going to go to war with him and fight him and really rough him up. Sometimes you don't need to win clean or win, you know, great fashion. You just need to do what you want to do. You know, against Parker, Dillian White knew that he could not outbox Parker, so he had to go there and rough him up. And he did that, and he won the fight. You saw that. He dropped Parker for the first time. Parker, before that, was never down, but he got down. You know, Dillian White is a dangerous guy. Don't underrate this guy, even though his stamina is still a little bit shaky, but against Usyk, he will have to interfere because he know that Usyk doesn't possess the power he possesses. He's just going to go there and rough him up. So we'll see what happens. Fighting AJ, Usyk is going to go up against a monster like AJ. It's going to be very interesting. I think Joshua knocks him out, but I think he gives Joshua trouble before Joshua knocks him out, because Usyk, you have to understand, this guy is a very, very good boxer. I mean, he's a boxing maestro. His footwork alone is impressive alone. I mean, I like it. So you've got to give the guy props. I mean, I have nothing bad to say about Usyk, because the guy has, I mean, he deserves everything he gets. You know what I mean? This guy, 15-5 undisputed, you know what I mean? So he has Muhammad Ali trophy. This guy has done a lot of things in just a short amount of time. You know, but the thing is that he's 31 years old and he's not getting younger, so he has to be rushed before he gets older, you know. So, but coming to the heavyweight division is a different bad game. It's going to meet monsters. That monsters you could outbox and all of a sudden when they catch you, it's less out, because the power of the heavyweights is just different. That's why we have weight classes for a reason. But nevertheless, I think he will give Joshua a good fight until he gets knocked out or gets stopped, because Joshua definitely will stop him. Joshua will not go there and try to outbox Usyk. He will go there standing toe-to-toe with him. And Joshua will have the reach advantage and a huge weight advantage as well. So Usyk is going to be fighting on his back foot against Joshua. He's not going to go there and try to trail with Joshua. He's going to go there and try to outbox Joshua, you know, use a jab, but the reach wouldn't be on his side. So it's going to be very interesting to see how he plays out. I think he outboxes a guy like Water, but it turns out that Water is a dangerous punch. If he catches you with that right hand, he's lights out as well. Water may look thin a little bit, skinny, but he's got the power of a re-heavyweight. and that's a trouble, or a huge trouble. You know, water can be outbossed by anyone, but the thing is that if it catches you, can you take the punch? And we have never seen Usyk, you know, got a little bit, you know, wobbled or shaky. Maybe against British, you can say, yeah, but that wasn't really a shaky situation. That was just, you know, what happens in fights. But we have never seen Usyk in a dangerous, you know, fight before. So we're going to have to see how it plays out. And when he steps up, like he says, you'll see what he has to offer in the erudition. But now, the heavyweight division will be so interesting. I love it. Give it a thumbs below, guys. Like the video, share, and please don't forget to subscribe.